Hello, Auburn High School families, parents, teachers, students. This is Mr. Gardner. I want to give you an update on school safety, building security, and that type of thing. We've had a pretty good start to the school year. We've had some issues. We've had some challenges. You know, I hear often that a lot of schools in the nation, in our area, are having challenges, things like that. The last thing that we ever want to do is normalize any type of negative or, you know, just poor behaviors. That's not what Auburn High School is going to be about. So I'm glad people say those things because I know we're all going through a lot of things that are different than maybe before the pandemic. But I also want to definitely say that, you know what, we can do better. And that's what this video is for. Starting on Monday, November 29th, in terms of school attendance, we're no longer going to be using the classroom scanners. Students are expected to be in their classroom by the time the tardy bell rings. When the tardy bell rings, the teachers are going to do their good things, take their attendance. Students who are tardy, each class, they're going to be given one freebie, two freebies. So two free tardies, you know, within reason. You can't show up 10 or 15 minutes tardy because at that point you're absent. But if you show a few minutes late, they're going to give you two freebies. If you're a student going from one end of the building, let's say all the way down from the health classroom in 719, and you got to go all the way up to one of the classrooms on the third floor, we know it's really challenging to get there in 5 minutes in crowded hallways. We get that. So you just need to work with your teachers, let them know you're getting there as fast as you can, and then do exactly that. If you're showing up late because you're dragging your feet, because you're stopping and talking to everybody, that's not going to be tolerated. We're only going to give you the two freebies, and that's all it's going to be. If you get to the third tardy, your teacher's going to have a conversation with you. They may just drop you an email saying that was your third tardy. You got to let me know what's going on, or you got to fix it. If you get to a fourth tardy in any one of your classrooms, they're now going to contact your parents to let you know that, or let them know that getting to class is going to be tough for you. We're partnering with parents and guardians to also have meaningful conversations with you about getting to class on time. Okay, one day or even for right now, many of you are working jobs. You have to be to your jobs on time. That's one of the last things employers want to work with the students, employers, anybody, or employees who show up late. Okay, life happens sometimes and we all get that. We can have a tire blowout. We could not set our alarm. Those things, they're facts of life. But to just not show up on time just because you think you can, that's not the way you're going to be able to hold a job one day. The other thing is, if you get to a fourth tardy, okay, they're going to contact your parents, like I said. But if you get to the fifth tardy, the teachers, that they're going to give you a 30-minute detention, probably in the form of a lunch detention. Okay, if you get summoned on one of those lunch detentions, you need to show up and serve it. Okay, hopefully nobody gets to that point, but if you do, serve it. Okay, now if we're talking the same quarter, okay, we're in quarter two right now. If you get to another tardy, you're then going to be referred to one of us, one of the administrators. At that point, we're also going to contact your parents. We're also going to have you do a little bit more time detained here at school, or going to have you work with campus beautification. We've got all kinds of things around the campus that could help us make this place a little bit better. So those are steps we're going to take to show you that it matters to show up on time. We care about your education. We care about you succeeding. And for the probably small percentage of students, I'm guessing, I don't know if we have anybody that go to this school, that feel like we're doing this to you. We're not. We're trying to get you set up for a successful future, a future where you can be an employable employee, somebody that can keep a job for a long time and hopefully continue to get better with your work and get all kinds of promotions. Same thing if you're off to college when you get done with high school. You know, you got to show up to class on time. There's professors out there that won't put up with this, okay? So this is for you. I know it doesn't always feel that way, but really you need to learn how to get to places on time. It really doesn't take a lot of talent to do that. You just got to tell yourself you're going to get it done. The other thing from a safety standpoint, those who park in our north lot, the student parking lot, we're going to keep the foyer, the gym foyer open until 8:20. Okay. So that means you're already late, excused or unexcused, 10 minutes to your first period class. We're going to have a tardy kiosk down there manned by Mrs. Skeel, our activity secretary, and she's going to let you punch in, or if you have to do the numbers or scan in with your card or your phone, and then you can get one of those green tickets and head straight to your first period. After 8:20, the only access point into this building is the main office, okay? I should say the main doors by the main office. Students arriving late, even if you have to park on the north end of campus, you're going to have to walk all the way around the building, even if it's really poor weather, okay? So dress for the weather, and you're gonna have to enter in through the attendance office. That's the only places we'll have attendance kiosks at that point. Students who show up late to any classes after arriving, you just go straight to class. There's no more going back to the attendance office to get one of those little green tickets. That's only for students who show up to school late. If you had a dental appointment and you don't get to school until second or third period, well, that's past 8:20. So you're gonna go through the main doors, go to the attendance office and work the tardy kiosk there and get sent to class. So that we're really trying to clean some things up around here. One of them has to do with you being on time, students. The other one is we're gonna keep our building secure. And the other part is we have students we have on camera who've let other people in the building. Just this quarter alone, or actually first quarter, we've actually had three people in this building that don't belong here. And all three people told us it was students that let them in, okay? We're going to be adding a little bit more disciplinary pieces to that. If we catch you on camera, which we've got cameras on every single exit in this building, it's going to be a serious matter. So just know that. So if you have one of your best friends or whatever texting you to come let you in the 100 East hallway or the 500 West hallway, you just need to ignore it. They can walk to the front of the school. They can walk through the main doors. They can go to the attendance office and not put you in a tough situation where you're being seen on a surveillance camera and getting yourself in trouble. If they're truly your friends, they won't text you. They'll go around and do what they're supposed to do. So just know that this all starts on November 29th, that Monday. I hope you guys all have a great parent-teacher conference. I hope you have a great Thanksgiving break. And I just wanna let you know the practices around here are gonna change a little bit. We wanna make sure everybody can be successful with them. And by being in class on time more often, chances are you're gonna have a better chance of engaging in your classes. And you probably will see your academic achievement go up just by virtue of being there all the time. So anyway, thank you for listening. If you have any questions, as always, email me or find me in the halls. Thank you.